Hi dear students, in last session we learned types of solids, that is crystalline solids and amorphous solids. Most of the solid substances are crystalline in nature. So in this session we will see classification of crystalline solids. We classify crystalline solids on the basis of interparticle forces and bonding. Crystalline solids are classified into four types: molecular solids, ionic solids, metallic solids, and covalent or network solids. Let's learn each one of this in detail. First is molecular solids, which is further divided into three categories, that is polar molecular solids, non-polar molecular solids, and hydrogen bonded molecular solids. Let's see one by one. Polar molecular solids. For learning all types of crystalline solids, we will see six important points. That is, constituent particles, bonding or interparticle forces, physical nature or hardness, melting point, thermal and electrical conductivity, and examples. Constituent particles in polar solids are polar molecules. In these solids, molecules are held by strong dipole-dipole interactions. These solids are soft in nature, and most of these are exists as gases or liquids at room temperature and pressure. That is, they have low melting point, but relatively higher than non-polar solids. They are non-conductors or insulators. Some examples of these solids are HCl, SO2, NH3, etc. Non-polar molecular solids. Constituent particles in non-polar solids are either non-polar molecules like H2, Cl2, I2, etc. or atoms of noble gases like argon, helium, etc. In these solids, atoms or molecules are held by weak dispersion or London forces. We have already learnt about this in 11th standard. These solids are soft in nature and exists as gases or liquids at room temperature and pressure. That is, they have low melting point. They are non-conductors or insulators. Some examples of these solids are argon, CCl4, H2, I2, CO2, etc. Hydrogen bonded molecular solids. Constituent particles in hydrogen bonded molecular solids are molecules. In these solids, molecules are held by strong hydrogen bonding. These solids are hard in nature and exists as volatile liquids or solids at room temperature and pressure and have low melting point. They are non-conductors or insulators. Example of these solids is H2O. Second type of crystalline solids is ionic solids. Constituent particles in ionic solids are ions. In these solids, ions are held by strong Coulombic or electrostatic force. These solids are hard and brittle in nature, and they have high melting point. Because of non-availability of ions for movement, they are insulators in solid state. But when dissolved in water, ions becomes free for movement and conduct electricity. Some examples of these solids are NaCl, MgO, ZnS, CaF2, KCl, KnO3, etc. Third type of crystalline solids is metallic solids. As shown in figure, constituent particles in metallic solids are positive ions present in sea of delocalized electrons. These electrons are mobile and are evenly spread out throughout the crystal. In these solids, bonding is metallic. These solids are hard and lustrous and malleable and ductile in nature. These solids have fairly high melting point. Because of free and mobile electrons, these solids are good heat and electricity conductors in solid state as well as in molten state. Some examples of these solids are Fe, Cu, Mg, Ag, Au, etc. Fourth and last type of crystalline solids is covalent or network solids. Constituent particles in covalent or network solids are non-metal atoms. In these solids, atoms are held by covalent bonding. These solids are hard in nature and have very high melting point. They are insulators and do not conduct electricity. Some examples of these solids are quartz, silicon carbide, diamond, etc. Graphite is also belongs to this class, but it is soft and conduct electricity. This is because in structure of graphite, carbon atoms are arranged in different layers and each atom is covalently bonded to three of its neighboring atoms in the same layer. The fourth valence electron of each atom is present between different layers and is free to move about. These free electrons make graphite a good conductor of electricity. Different layers can slide one over the other. This makes graphite a soft solid and a good solid lubricant. This is the one view of classification of crystalline solids. With this, we came at the end of session. In next session, we will learn about crystal lattices and unit cells. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends and do subscribe our channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon.